Thanks, everybody, for joining me for my weekend forecast. We're going to take a look at the weather for July 25th and 26th. And so the weather this weekend is going to be boring to forecast, but great to live through. It's amazing. This is basically a perfect forecast, perfect weekend for late July. It's going to be very summer-like. Warm but not hot and not that humid. Basically about as good as you could possibly see. It'll cool off pretty good at night. We're going to see lows around 60 both Saturday and Sunday morning. Highs in the mid-80s both days. So really ideal weather. Let's take a quick look and look at why that's going to happen. Here's your upper level map. Essentially, we've been looking at patterns very similar to this. There's been a dominant ridge over the eastern two-thirds of the country, actually sometimes over almost the entire country. And that's going to take place here. Right now we're in a bit of a, we're getting a little bit of a flow and almost a little bit of a trough here on Thursday as some showers and thunderstorms move through, but those are going to be done with us by Friday, or actually mostly by tonight, Thursday night, for those of you, for my patrons getting this on Thursday, but for everybody else, you'll see this on Friday. The storms will have rolled through and Friday's going to be beautiful, and then we're going to be underneath this high pressure dome for a couple days, but we're not into the southwest flow where we're really pumping the deep moisture up here, so it's going to be plenty warm to hot, but not unusual for this time of year, and really just a nice day. So let's take a quick look at what that looks like from a forecast perspective. So Saturday, mostly sunny, not very humid, pretty good sleeping weather on Friday night, morning lows near 60, afternoon highs in the mid-80s. Really just a great day. Sunday is basically a carbon copy. Almost exactly the same forecast. Going to be basically mostly sunny. Could have a few fair weather clouds, but same kind of thing. Lows near 60, highs in the mid-80s. So try to get out there and enjoy that this weekend. It's great, really great for any kind of July outdoor activity. If you're hiking, it's great. If you're going to be at the beach, it's going to be great. Really, whatever you want to do. If you're going for some heavy-duty exercise in the mid-afternoon, it could be a little warm, but, you know, it's July. That's pretty typical for this time of year. Basically, really nice weather. Did want to take a quick look at a couple of tropical systems. Whoops, that's the wrong slide. There we go. Tropical systems. The tropics have been busy so far this year. Neither one of these is going to impact our weather. At least it doesn't seem like that at all. But I'm going to just point out the tropics because it's when they're this busy this early, it usually means we could be in for kind of a long tropical season. And if you've been with me over the last few weeks, I've talked about how a few of the named storms early were maybe questionable tropical systems. These are definitely fully tropical systems. This is a depression, but it's going to become Tropical Storm Hanna here, probably in the Gulf of Mexico, and make a run at the South Texas coast. Won't have time to get too strong, but it is certainly going to give them a lot of rain there. And then over here, actually, this is already a tropical storm. This is a zoomed out view, so it's hard to see, but this is east of the Lesser Antilles, so still out kind of in the central Atlantic. But this is currently Tropical Storm Gonzalo, and this is going to be probably our first hurricane. So even though we're going to be approaching our eighth storm of the season very soon, we haven't had a hurricane yet. They've all been tropical storms. This will probably become a hurricane as it traverses through the Southern Caribbean. Doesn't look to get too strong. We're still a little early for tropical weather in the year. But anyways, just wanted to give you an update on that. We'll have to keep an eye on the tropics because when it's this busy this early, that can sometimes mean we're in for a pretty busy season. And of course, when it comes to tropical weather, it's really not about how many storms you have. It's about the ones that happen to hit land. And obviously here in Vermont, the ones that kind of head up our direction. So all it takes is one right storm to make a season bad. But it bears watching just because there's been a lot of tropical activity already. So anyways, hope you have a safe and fun weekend. Get out there, enjoy that beautiful weather. And we'll be back on Monday morning at 7 a.m. on Facebook Live with my work week forecast. Till then, I want to thank my patrons who help make this happen here at the West River Weather Guy. They help by providing me with some of the funds in order to make improve my equipment and also to help provide you with a couple forecasts each week. They help really support the channel, so I appreciate that. And certainly if you want to become somebody who helps support the channel in more than just a watching way, we appreciate the watchers. But if you want to help out as a patron, we'd invite you to join. You can do that by following the links below that are posted in the discussion or in the description of this video.